after we completed the Guaco Tower, our flagship development, we were looking for another potentially transformative site to acquire. So when the Beach Road mixed development site came up, which comprised majority office, some mixed users in it, we were very excited. This site was almost like the last piece of a major mixed development site, really complete that transformation along that corridor. Lifestyle is very much related to development concept. Part of conceiving of the development concept is also looking at changing trends, future trends, and we try to also lead the market by introducing new concepts that relates to how things are evolving. Although our project is huge, but we consciously try to introduce that human skill back into the project. That's why we introduce little streets and we have low-scale buildings that line some of these streets and plazas. And then we have three retail villages clustered around a public space. A successful public space must be in the right location. Being in a strong connection to the MRT and having a lot of catchment surrounding it is an important requisite. But we also believe it will contribute greatly to the city as well, because it will make it very porous for people to move around. A public realm that people can all identify as the place to go to.
Concept for Midtown Modern is really, we're trying to get away from the ubiquitous sort of steel and glass and aluminium kind of tower. So what we're trying to do is to create a sanctuary in the city, a sense of timelessness, something that will withstand the test of time, and also hopefully sort of a wilder beauty in the city. What we have is a best of both worlds in that area. There's a lot of buzz on the ground floor. Basically, there's art and culture, there's entertainment. But if you get tired of that, within minutes, you sort of escape to the upper stories where your apartment is. There you will find peace and tranquility to create this sort of duality where you can sort of escape within minutes to a quiet sanctuary.
In terms of landscape, here we actually adopted the concept of having gardens in the woods, creating multiple landscape settings with variants. How we do that is we imagine the landscape deck being covered almost 90% of the entire site. Give us the opportunity to create multiple zones where people could experience different parts of a landscape environment. Curated gardens consist of woodlands, a lawn, ponds and wetlands. Conventionally in a condominium, people go to a certain place for a particular function, but Midtown Modern landscape is like an exploration of nature. With these different kind of settings, one can feel that they are actually moving or exploring the mountains, the hills, come into a different setting when they reach a certain level or a certain terrain. What we want residents and visitors to feel inspired at every turns and corner on this landscape.
Amongst our ID consultants as well as our architect, one of the observations is sort of new form of luxury aesthetic emerging, particularly from Europe, whereby things are a lot more muted and understated. And so that's something that we have introduced here in Midtown Modern.
I mean, of course, the rough texture, the colours, in this case, we are using rough plaster with a brown terracotta kind of colour. What it does is, of course, it evokes this warmth and coziness within the development. But this material is not afraid to take a few knocks. The planning of all these units is actually in such a way that every room would have a spectacular view. So that is why they are all so jagged. So when the plan is like that, so what we thought we could actually translate that jaggedness into a language that pervades throughout. Basically, what we're trying to create here is actually an arrival to a lobby of light coming down to the ground area. So depending on what time you come home, very early in the morning, in the daytime, the light is more intense and the mood is very different. But when you come back at night, where the light is more subdued and artificial lights come on, then the mood changes to something else. So this is a form of delight that we hope to try and bring to this lobby space that makes it somehow different.
In our many years of development, perhaps what we have given less emphasis to is our own well-being. And that could be physical or mental or even spiritual. The idea of having lots of green spaces where you can go and chill, space out or whatever is important for that mental well-being.
A biophilic design approach helps to bring out the wellness of individual. We envision from a resort-style environment or resort that inspired by nature, make use of what nature can give, and then allow the visitors or the residents or the guests to feel pampered by being in nature. In our urban setting, there's something that we are really, really lack of, and we want to bring nature back into Midtown Modern. Nature in a way that at the most traditional form.
We're not after very acrobatic architecture. We're not after it to be being very iconic, you know, for a sculpture for the city. First and foremost, it's really for people to live in, for people to grow old in, for people to create a history with their family. And even though it's done very, it looks very simple, but actually there are many, many layers to it. And it will take time for you to discover. And that's the beauty. It's like a good friendship. You get on well, but then actually there are many, many things that you would discover through time.
So when projects are relatively new, I think they are very similar. But the real test is when time has passed. How will the projects, how will the developments age? How will the users, the community change through time? We have to take a district and neighborhood mentality when we do development, but subsequently the way we manage our trade mix and so on. Because the concept is the Chinese saying, right? 水涨船高. So if the entire neighborhood get uplifted, if our neighbors do better, we will also benefit from them doing better. What we hope it will do is it becomes a blueprint, a demonstration of what a great project could be. Hopefully it can help to inspire others to use some of the ideas to do even better projects.